You know, the Tempest has so much magic in it, so there's the temptation of loading it up with stuff. A very decorative production. It's not what we're interested in.
This is such a different challenge, you know? Two different directors working with Jan and Jade, even though we know each other and we think a great deal alike. The work is monumental.
Now, you know, at this hour lies at my mercy all mine enemies. How wonderful is that? I mean, all of us dream of, you know, revenge, or, you know, we've been hurt and we just think, what a gift that is, you know, to our darker sides.
The point is, he's alone with his thoughts and his daughter and these two inhabitants of the island.
You know, he's somebody that fell asleep on the job. He made a mistake, and that mistake cost him.
A lot of our imagery headed in that direction. Abandoned places, abandoned pools, and what happens when nature kind of comes in and takes over.
And the music's beautiful. It's been composed. It's very otherworldly.
I just respond to the Shakespeare because there's an elegance to it. It's just so well done that I feel like I'm learning from it. Or, you know, it's almost easier to put music underneath it because it stands so well on its own.
Most of the stuff that we are using for Tempest is completely made from scratch.
And then, of course, there's the water, which is everybody's guess as to how this is going to play itself out. I mean, it's contained, but it's also has a mind of its own.
We're interested in a sort of magic where you can see the strings that's happening in the room.
We are such stuff as dreams are made on, and our little life is rounded with a sleep.